Hello students, in this video you are going to study about verbs. Read the following sentences. Number 1, the woman cleans the room. Number 2, the children wait for the bus. Number 3, the baby laughed. And number 4, Mr. Gupta went to Mumbai yesterday. In these 4 sentences, you can see cleans, wait, laughed, and went. These are the actions. And they tell us what the subjects of the sentences do or did. Means, these action words tell us about the work done by the subjects like woman, children, baby, and Gupta. These are the subjects and they have done the actions like cleans, wait, laughed and went. So now let's see what are the verbs. The words which express an action or tell something about a sentence are called verbs. So, the words that tell us about the actions or the work done by the subject in the sentence are called verbs. Verbs are also called action words or doing words. Examples: eat, run, dance, taste, see, teach, write, laugh, send, etc. All these are the examples of verb and these are also called action words or doing words. A verb is the most important part of a sentence. Without a verb, we cannot form a sentence. So let's understand this with the help of example. Number 1, Nina to school. Here you can see this group of words is giving no complete sense. Something is missing in this group of words. Number 2, Tanya pretty. Again, here we are not getting any sense from this group of words. Now what is missing in this group of words? Let's find out. Number 1, Meena goes to school. Now here you can see goes. Goes is the action word or the verb that was missing in the first sentence. Now when we used verb in the sentence, it has given us a complete meaning. Meena goes to school. Here this sentence is giving you a complete sense. Tanya is pretty. Again, you can see this sentence is complete now and it is giving you a complete sense. So, without a verb, we cannot form a meaningful sentence. Verbs are words that express an action, possession, and state of being. So, let's understand these points with the help of examples. Examples for verbs showing actions. Number 1, Jyoti plays the piano. Number 2, she comes to school on her bicycle. Number 3, the boy plays in the garden. Number 4, she studies very hard. Here you can see the word plays, comes, and studies. These words express actions. They tell us what a subject does. Subject can be a noun or pronoun. So, the work done by the subject is action. works showing state of being. Let's understand it with the help of examples. Number one, Meena is a student. Here you can see is. This verb shows the state of being. Like Meena is a student. This is verb is telling us that Meena is a student. It is telling us the condition or the state of Meena. Number 2, Mrs. Verma was a kind lady. Again, you can see here was. Was verb shows that it is shows that what kind of lady Mrs. Verma was. A kind lady, telling the state of being. They are good insans. Here verb are. This is again showing us the state of being. Means they are good in science. This is telling the condition. So the words is, was, are tell us about the subject. They do not tell us about what the subject is doing, but they are telling us what they are. Now, the verbs showing possession. Possession means honor, ownership, or the things that belongs to the other person or the thing. Examples, Reena and Tina have a new pet. Here you can see have. This verb is showing the possession. Means Reena and Tina have a new pet. Here, a new pet belongs to Reena and Tina. The dog has a small tail. Again, has verb shows the possession. Dog has a small tail. They have a beautiful garden. Here, have verb shows possession and it shows that the beautiful garden belongs to they. So the words have and has show that what belongs to the subject. They are not telling us about the actions or the conditions of the subject. They are telling us what belongs to the subject. Now the types of verb. There are two types of verbs. Number one, main verbs, also known as principal verbs or lexical verbs. Number two, helping verbs or auxiliary verbs. Now let's study about these types of verbs in detail. There are 24 helping verbs and these helping verbs are further divided into two parts. Number one, primary helping verbs. You have already studied about this is, am, are, was, were, does, did, has, have and had. These all verbs come under the category of primary helping verbs. Number two, modals. Shall, should, will, would, may, might, can, could, must, ought to, need, dare, and used to. All these verbs are under modals. Primary verbs are also called double duty verbs. Double duty verbs means they work both as helping verbs and main verbs. As they play the double role, so they are called double duty verbs. What are main verbs? the words that actually show the action or the activity of subject. So main verbs are the action words or the actual action or activity of the subject. They can stand alone and give complete meaning to the sentence. Means in the sentence they can give complete meaning independently without the help of any other word or any other verb. Let's understand this point with the help of example. He reads a story. Here you can see reads. This is main verb and no any other verb is used with it, and it is giving you a complete meaning. He reads a story. They play football. Again, in this sentence we can see play. Play is main verb, main action, and it is giving a complete meaning to the sentence. Helping verbs. So what are helping verbs? When they act as helping verb, they give more meaning to the main verb. Helping verb name indicates that they are used to help the main verb. They give more meaning to the main verb. They cannot stand alone. They require main verb for their existence. Like main verbs, they cannot give the complete meaning to the sentence. They need main verb for their existence. Only then they can give you the meaning. So let's understand this point with the help of example. She is singing a song. Here is verb is helping verb and it is giving more meaning to singing. Singing is main verb. We are enjoying the party. Are. It is helping verb and it is used with the main verb enjoying. Now read the given sentences. A bus has, number 2, Rahul and Anita are, number 3, my mother is. Here you can see has, are and is verbs are used. They are not giving you any complete sense. These are helping verbs, and helping verbs alone cannot give a complete sense to the sentence. They require main verbs. Now read these sentences when we add main verbs to these helping verbs. Number 1, the bus has arrived. Has helping verb and arrived main verb. Now this sentence is complete with complete sense. Number 2, Rahul and Anita are watching TV. Are helping verb and watching main verb. Number 3, my mother is going to market. Is helping verb and going main verb. So these examples shows that helping verbs alone cannot give the meaning to the sentences. They are used with main verbs. So when the helping verbs are followed by main verbs, they give a complete sense to the sentences. In this video, we studied about verbs. We learned that verbs are action or doing words. Verbs express an action, possession, and the state of being. We also studied about the types of verbs. Number one, main verbs. Words that actually show the action or the activity of subject. Number two, helping verbs. They give more meaning to the main verb. In the next video, we will study more about verbs. Thank you.